please subscribe to our channel. In order to get notifications and updates, click on the bell icon below.
So what is cloud computing? What are the cloud characteristics, different service models? What are the deployment models in cloud? Advantages and disadvantages of cloud computing? And then the very important thing, cloud computing job roles. And finally, what are the cloud computing platforms and certifications which are available in the industry? This is what we are going to discuss in this particular chapter. Very important, in this particular chapter, we are not going to talk about Azure, nothing specific to Azure. Whatever I'm discussing here, it's common in general cloud computing. So what is cloud? You should remember, cloud is just nothing but internet, actually speaking. From the layman's angle, if I explain you, cloud is just a metaphor for the internet. So whenever we are referring to the word cloud, we are referring to internet. This is very clear. So what is that we need to actually discuss is cloud computing. See, whenever we are talking about internet, we actually use internet for various purposes nowadays. We use internet for storing data. You have got drives which are provided by Google, Microsoft, and so on, where data can be stored. We have internet where applications are executed. We have internet where different services of different people we are making use of, different applications we are making use of. So we use internet for chatting. We use internet for support. We use internet for almost everything in today's day-to-day life. So what is cloud computing here? Cloud computing basically means we are having the ability of storing and accessing data, and programs. That means the applications over the internet. Instead of doing this on our local computer, we are doing this on the internet. Precisely that is what is cloud computing. See, the practice of using the network of remote servers hosted on the internet to store, manage, and process data rather than local server or personal computer. That's actually the Google definition of cloud computing also. So that means we are now moving storage from our local computer to something on internet. We are moving processing from our local computer to something else on internet. That means remote servers are what we are trying to make use of now. And that is what we call it as cloud computing. That means our local computer can be as small as a mobile, or even if it is a high speed computer with lot of RAM and lot of processor, you're not using anything of that except the browser and the internet connectivity. So your clients will become thin clients now. Very old days, how thin clients were there and everything was happening on server. Back are those days, I would say. So though our computers are powerful, PC computers are powerful, we are shifting everything to cloud. We are shifting everything to internet. We are shifting everything to a remote server. Remote server is what? Something which is hosted by a service provider. That remote server, again, can be managed by we people only when we take a dedicated server, or it can be managed by some XYZ vendor because they will take care of providing the complete hardware infrastructure. So in cloud computing, there is a third party service provider who is responsible for providing to us all the required hardware. That means all the servers, all the software which are going to manage that particular server, and also in many cases the application, the softwares also will be provided. So the phrase cloud computing means the type of internet based computing where the different servers, storage servers, applications, everything such as server, storage, application are all delivered to an organization computer through internet only. So obviously, without internet, we cannot expect cloud computing to happen. Refers to variety of services available over internet that are delivered computing functionality on service providers' infrastructure. A cloud computing consists of highly optimized data centers. So this is the key here. See, every organization has got its own data center. But now we are talking about moving our data center from within the premise to a remote location. And rather, in most of the cases, it is not just one data center which comes into the scene. We will have multiple data centers where our data and our applications are going to reside. So these data centers are what actually taken care by the service provider. Microsoft has got data center, Amazon has got data center like that. Google has got its own data center where they are providing to us the service in the form of Microsoft is giving Azure through their data center. Amazon is giving AWS through their data center. Google is also having their own cloud infrastructure to which that also is given access to the general public. So basically, yes, the general public on paid basis, of course, will have access to the infrastructure managed by the service provider. What is the advantage? One simple advantage, it hides the complexity. That's it. One bottom line, I could say. It hides the complexity. I don't need to see the data center. I don't need to manage the power for that data center. I don't need to do administration of the data center. I don't need to take care of the direct backup and restore of the data center. I don't need to take care of the hardware failure of the data center. All that thing, which is considered to be complex task, is now taken care by the service provider themselves. I would simply host my applications and I would let my users use those applications. I would put my data and the applications or the users are going to make use of that data. And very importantly, it can happen through a simple browser interface. We are going to manage all our applications, all our data through a simple browser interface in most of the cases. But at the same time, there is also alternative provided so that we can do some kind of customization to it through APIs. Application programming interfaces are also given to us for managing our applications and data. The cloud computing platform provides on-demand service. This is the beauty of it. It is always on. It is anywhere, anytime, any place. That is the concept on which all the cloud platforms are going to work. Why are businesses moving to cloud? Everybody knows the problem with traditional hosting. We are just given a server. We call that as a dedicated server. And on that server, we have to install the operating system. Sometimes the vendor does it for us. But any kind of upgrade, we have to do on that server. We have to take care of the licenses for different softwares which we are going to use. And if some software is used only for a short period of time, but we'll still have to buy the license and thereafter we may not use it. We have to take care of the upgradations of the softwares. And every time the upgradation happens, we have to buy the new software. We have to take care of the protection of the data. Security of the data is in our hand. We have to ensure that proper firewalls are provided and are configured. I mean, in general, I would say a lot of our tasks will be simply dedicated to the cloud platform by just getting into the cloud. See, for me, it is as simple as this. I can either use a garden in my own house or I can make use of a society garden. The only advantage of society garden is low maintenance, all benefits. But yeah, it is not private. It is not private. That's there. But if the garden maintenance people, there is, let us say, a dedicated garden maintenance people, if they bring certain rules and regulations, it can be as good as our own lawn or own garden in-house, and the cost will be surely very less. So I would say that is how the cloud is. Or you put it like this: a child should be given a private tuition at home, or should he be sent to school? You have to decide. Now you might say in school he is not safe, but at the same time you have to learn in school he is going to get so many services which he cannot get probably at home. Same is precisely the difference between hosting applications in on-premise and in cloud. In on-premise, we have to activate and install and maintain all the services which our applications would need. Whereas in cloud, they are just provided to us, they are given to us at our disposal. We have to only activate them. It's like a switch. Switch on, use it. Don't need, switch off. And only for the moment it is on, we are paying for it. Otherwise, we don't have to pay for it. So that is how the difference I would say is. Yeah, if I send my child to school, I have to choose the right school which ensures the security of my child. I have to choose a school which gives proper nurturing to my child. That's my job. That is where the organizations will have to make a decision about who is going to be the service provider for them. I have to choose also on the basis of what kind of services I'm going to get in the school. Some schools will take care of only teaching. Some schools will take care of only sports. Some schools we will have teaching, sports, extracurricular, this, that. I mean, we have to opt for them. Obviously, the cost will grow when we opt for them. The cost may not be high if we don't opt for them. So it's precisely our decision to move our applications from on-premise to cloud only to take all those benefits of cloud which are provided to us through service provider in the form of various services. Everything is a service. So that's what is precisely the benefit the world has started identifying in moving from on-premise to cloud. Earlier, only I would say large organizations were doing it. Now even small and mid-level organizations see some kind of benefit in the cloud infrastructure. Let's look at now the cloud characteristics. Now these are the things which every cloud service provider has to take care of. It is supposed to be remotely hosted. Yes, it cannot be in on-premise. It has to be remotely hosted. Actually, I said it is not only hosted in one location. Most of the times, to replicate the content, to make the content reliable, secure, it is hosted in multiple locations. Ubiquitous, yes, it is present everywhere and it is accessible from anywhere through internet. That's what is ubiquitous. Resilient, we will always have the mirror copies on different data centers, so that if the copy goes down in one data center, maybe because of the flood or cyclone or war or whatever, our data should still become available from another data center. So resiliency is a very, very important feature or characteristics of cloud. On-demand self-service. A consumer can himself provision computing capabilities. That means I should be able to bring up the server on demand. I should be able to set the network configuration on demand. There should not be any human interaction. That's how every cloud service provider should be able to. It should not be like I book an order and the order is going to execute in next 24 hours and we'll get back to you. No, that kind of response should not be there. I should be able to do few clicks here and there and my server should be up and running. I should have SQL Server on the fly. I should have SharePoint on the fly. I should have maybe SAP also on the fly. Something like that we want now. So that should be on demand. Rapid elasticity. This is very, very important characteristics. We should be able to expand the configuration or shrink the configuration. We generally call it as scale up, scale down, scale out, scale in. We should be able to scale in general the configuration of the servers so that based on the load, the configuration can be changed. When I have high traffic, I allocate lots of resources. When I have low traffic, I deallocate the resources, I shrink it. So we want that elasticity facility also within the cloud infrastructure. Broad network access. It should be accessible from any kind of device. We don't want to restrict to any particular type. We should be able to use it from laptops, desktops. We should be able to use it from laptops, desktop, mobile phones, tablets, anything. It should be fully managed by the provider, the most key factor. I should not have in-house administrators now. For everything, the administrator role is shifted to the provider. Database administrator, they will take care of. Network administrator, they will take care of. So all these administrator roles will be to a major extent moved to the service provider. So our job will be what? Develop application, host application, configure application, access application, test application, that's it. Manage data. These are the only things which we would want to do. So these are the very important characteristics of cloud. Remotely hosted, ubiquitous, resilient, on-demand self-service, rapid elasticity, broad network access, fully managed by the provider. And this is what I would say differentiates a cloud from a dedicated hosting or a semi-dedicated hosting on internet. So you see, earlier to cloud, what was the option available? I still buy a server from somebody on internet. I either buy it as a dedicated hosting, or I buy it as a semi-dedicated hosting, or I may also buy some cases as shared hosting based on my budget. But in all cases, I don't get these facilities. They have to be taken care of by me only. I have to ensure that I buy two servers. I have to ensure that I take care of replicating data on two servers. I have to ensure that I should take regular backups. Everything I will have to do. This thing is all now shifted into cloud service provider's profile. Basically, on-demand self-service implies what? With few clicks, I should be able to provision services. If I want a new server, I should not order, make payment, and then wait for it to be brought up and given access to me. That would take probably a day or two, in some cases 1 week also. I should be able to just say few clicks and my server should be up and running. That's what is on-demand self-service. Just on demand, it should be ready. And very importantly, we pay for what we use. We call it as pay as you go model. So that is what every cloud is supposed to provide us. Cloud service provider is supposed to provide us. Let's quickly now look at the cloud computing service models. Now, what are these service models? So cloud computing service models. Now, what are these? We have basically three models: infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. Now, what is the difference between all the three? Now, when we say infrastructure as a service, majorly we are only buying hardware from the service provider. I repeat, in infrastructure as a service, we are only purchasing hardware from the service provider. Basically, we will provision. Purchase also is a wrong word actually. We will only provision the required hardware for installing our software from the service provider. But after we provision the hardware, we have to take care of everything. So, delivers computer infrastructure, typically a virtual platform is given to us. So what the service provider does is he will bring lots of machines together, computing power of lot of machines together, and they will create a virtualization environment. From that virtualization environment, you will be given little computing speed. You will be given little amount of RAM. You will be given little amount of storage. That means in a very large infrastructure, we are given a small block for usage. Cloud providers build data centers. They take care of managing power. They scale on demand. They provide the complete hardware. They do the networking for us. They take care of the storage. They do all the distribution of the systems. Everything they take care of it for us. Rather than purchasing hardware, software, data center space or network requirement, clients instead buy those resources as fully outsourced service. So the only difference is I don't have to now by the operating system. I don't have to now buy the hardware. I don't have to now probably buy, in certain cases, something like SQL Server license. I would simply